There are two types of links in Linux, soft and hard. Soft links are the popular ones, also known as symbolic links or symlinks for short. Hard links may be a bit hard to grasp at first, but you've seen them around and this video is gonna clear it all up. To create either type of link, we use the ln command, which stands for link. We're about to look at some use cases that truly leverage the powerful mechanic of linking. Welcome to Nick's Tricks. I am Nick and this is ln. How's it going, guys? In today's video, we're looking at links in Linux, soft links and hard links, the difference between them, when and how to use them, and more importantly, what makes them the ideal solution to so many scenarios out in the wild. Let's start with the symbolic links. As a very basic analogy, if you're used to shortcuts on your desktop and Windows, you can think of symlinks in the same way. Difference is, symlinks act exactly as the files that they reference, so you can use them almost interchangeably. But shortcuts are just files with the LNK extension. They are specific to Windows and all you can do about them is to double-click them. This key difference comes from the way this is implemented and the level that it operates on. In Windows, shortcuts are created and managed at the operating system level. In Linux, symbolic links are part of the file system structure and are independent from the operating system shell. Time to look at the ln command. I gave it away in the example, didn't I? Just take a look at the screen, please. Time to look at the ln command. You will want to create symbolic links most of the time, so we use the S flag for that. The rest of the syntax is similar to the copy and move commands. The first argument will be the path to the resource that we are trying to link, and the second one is the name of the link or full path to it. If you don't provide a second argument, the name of your link will match the one of your target. In a Linux environment, links are special files, but they are files nonetheless, so you cannot have two files with the same name within the same directory. You can tell the difference between a regular file and a symlink by looking at the output of ls-l. That's your list command with a long listing format argument. If you haven't seen my video about ls, definitely go check it out after this. The link is in the description and also up here somewhere. One important note here. Just like on Windows, a symlink is nothing more than a reference to another file or directory. If you delete the original resource, your actual data is gone and the symlink is broken. That's why it's also called a soft link. A symlink can in fact exist without a reachable target and you can create them like that from the get-go. A broken symlink will keep pointing to its target whether or not it's actually there and therefore can be fixed by making sure that the target becomes available. You can also override an existing symlink by using the F flag for force, so you're assigning it a different resource as a target. Another cool thing about symlinks is that they can point to a relative path. Watch what happens if I make a symlink to this file from one level above and then I move the symlink around. It now expects to be able to reach its target one level even higher than where we started off. If I create a new target for it, I now have a symlink that points to different things based on its context. The possibilities are endless. Transparent redirection. If you have an application that frequently uses data from a slow storage device, you can move the data to a faster one and just link it without modifying any application code or configuration. Shared configurations. If you have multiple instances of an application using the same configuration, you can link it instead of copying it, and further changes will propagate automatically. Centralized log management. Instead of storing log files separately for different applications, you can create symlinks to a centralized log directory for easier monitoring. 99.9% of the time, you're going to want to be using soft links, but hard links do exist and you already use them. Let's create an example from scratch and understand what's happening. To create a hard link, we can simply just use the ln command without the S flag. I want to draw the attention to this little number here after the ACLs in the listing. As I mentioned in my video about LS, this is the number of hard links. If I create another hard link, this goes up to 3, as all of these files are now interlinked. If you're not familiar with inodes, you're about to see some dark magic. We have 3 files here, 1 gigabyte each. Hold on to something. How much do you think they all take? Are you sitting down? 1 gigabyte. We can do this a couple of more times. From the listing, you would think this is 5 gigs, but it's still 1. These files are hard-linked, so they point to the same file. I can append the string to either one of them, and they will all reflect the change. It gets better. I'm moving one of them away. It's not even the original. Then I go up and I remove the entire directory. My file is still there and it still takes up 1 gigabyte and it still has my string at the end of it. And that's how hard links differ from copies. I don't want to leave you hanging, so let me just show you what's going on under the hood. Making a directory for my file and moving it inside again, I am now going to create a soft link and a hard link. Let's look at ls with the I flag for inodes, also known as index nodes. In addition to all the goodies, we now have the inode number to the left, and we can notice that the hard link shares the same inode with the original file, whereas the symlink is in fact using an independent inode. There are two limitations to keep in mind when working with hard links. One, they have to be on the same file system, since that's the scope of the inodes. Two, you cannot create hard links for directories. That would create some really ugly recursive issues. And since I mentioned that you have in fact seen and even used hard links before, let's look no further than the dot and dot dot entries in every directory. Those are hard links provided by the file system to reference the current and parent directories, and you can check their inodes with ls-i. And as a matter of fact, this is why all directories have at least 2 hard links. And also why most of the time you can actually anticipate the number of subdirectories you can find inside by subtracting 2 from the number of hard links that you see there. The use of hard links provides several benefits compared to copying files. We're talking about space efficiency, time efficiency as they are created instantly and take up no additional space whatsoever, data consistency since the content is technically the same across all links, and preserving metadata. They are used internally for backup strategies, versioning and tracking by all sorts of utilities that leverage this important mechanism to improve performance by reducing I/O disk operations. I really hope you enjoyed this video and that your data was safely backed up before you tried anything potentially dangerous at home, like deleting stuff to save space and leaving just a trail of broken symlinks behind. This would be the time to like the video, subscribe, and hit that bell. Have a great day, I'll see you in the next one, and please look at the screen one more time.